Hello everyone, we have with us Karma Paljor and he has been one of the esteemed speakers at TEDxSMIT. We are going to talk with him. Welcome to Sikkim News, sir.
Thank you.
Sir, how has been your homecoming to Sikkim?
Well, it's been great, this time we've have a loss in our family. So it is a difficult time for our family, but I made it a point to come here because I had promised the students that I'd come and speak. So despite what's happened at home, I'm here today, here and now, because that's what I believe in. I need to be here for the students. I'm here and then going back.
So we are really sad for your loss. And so next is, like, the journalism in Sikkim is very much different than the journalism outside the state. So how do you see that difference, and how can that difference be bridged, that gap?
I don't think it's different. See, what happens is that in a small place like Sikkim, I've grown up here seeing journalists being attacked all the time. If they write anything against the administration, against a person who's powerful. So that kind of fear, psychosis has been present in journalism. Despite that, there are reporters who do good work. The need of the hour is to come out of that. I don't know how. We will need some fearless journalists to come out. We've had some in the past who've spoken out, who've done some great journalism. That is the need of the hour. Again, you asked me about journalism and how it has changed and how it's different from the rest of India. It is not. Journalism is the same everywhere. You know, you are a journalist, you observe, you investigate, you reflect on that, and then you report for the rest of the world to see. You know, your reports have to be impactful. What's happening in the rest of India today is also same. All journalists are being intimidated. There are few journalists who are fearless, who stand out. So journalists being intimidated has not been new here. It's new in India, I guess, in certain parts, but that's always been there. It is for the journalists to step out and do good journalism, and that's the challenge.
So you hail from Sikkim, a small place in India, and you today too, you had the topic that my birthplace does not define my destiny. So could you give our viewers a small description of what you spoke on the stage? It's rather an interesting topic.
Well, you know, you need to break out. So first I talked about ghettos. You know, ghettos, I mean, your comfort zone. So when you're from Sikkim, you tend to stay with students from Sikkim or students from Darjeeling, Nepal, where you're comfortable with. Suddenly they become your brothers and sisters. When you're from India, you travel to study to UK, US, wherever. Then the entire India and even China and Pakistan becomes your cousins and friends and all. Suddenly you find that comfort zone. My idea was always to break away from that mold. I stayed with a Gujarati family as a paying guest, learnt about their culture. I had friends who were all Kannadigas. I learned to speak in their language, you know. So doing that, your horizons, your widen. Then you need to learn so much more. So you need to break away from this. Break away from the cycle of your comfort zone. Reach out, do different things. I also talk to the students about doing one thing that you're scared about all the time. You know, you have to do things. You have to take fear head on and do it. And that will help you succeed.
Thank you, sir. And finally, talking about the broader aspect in the country, journalism is thought to be the fourth pillar of democracy. But nowadays, it's turning into more of a show business. So are you satisfied with this POV?
Yes, it has turned out into show business. The sad fact is that there are many television channels today who are mere, voice of the government, voice of the establishment. That certainly needs to change. I don't know how it'll change. But my entire focus and my vision now is that the regional news media will change that. Like around the world, like in the US, the power of regional media is immense, you know. A media channel or a media, digital media channel or newspaper in Sikkim will have a far bigger impact in this region than the rest of India. You do not need to be heard in the rest of India. A channel for Assam, a channel for Arunachal, a channel for those consolidated 8 states. So that will bring about change. If you think that only national media brings about change, that's a wrong notion. You know where national media is going today, some of them. The other big thing, of course, from here on is digital media. Social media has changed the way, news is being given out today. Now, everyone with a smartphone and a voice is a reporter. So you have thousands of reporters. But the only fear is that how you differentiate between real news and fake news. That's the next challenge. I think journalists of tomorrow will be more of gatekeepers, fact checkers, and the reporting will come. It'll come from the ground. It'll come from everywhere. You know, if there's a tragedy that's happening in Lachung or Lachen, the local people with their smartphones will reach first. There's no need for a journalist to be airlifted and reach there. But then it's the job of the journalist to verify, package the news in a better manner, and give it out to the rest of the world. That I see being the future of journalism, and that is what we are trying at eastmojo.com, to integrate, to train citizen journalists, campus reporters, and have them ready for this next round of news. And the journalists will also have to primarily now do data journalism, in-depth journalism. So when you do in-depth journalism, there will be a need for experts. You know, if I need to dig out data of the last 5 years of the deaths that have happened in Gantok STNM hospital, I'll need an expert to do that.
Yes.
You know, that is data journalism and why those deaths have happened. That is what is needed next. The other thing is needed is strong RTI journalists. Not the RTI journalists that are there today who get an RTI, blackmail people, and that's how they make their earning. Yes. That is not RTI journalism, but the RTI journalism in the real sense. So they will be able to get data and reports out to the people. I think that will be the future of journalism.
Thank you, sir. This was Karma S. Paljor speaking to Sikkim News. It was rather an interesting, a very informative talk with him. This is Ketan Mangla from SMIT.